Paul Brand was a medical doctor who spent much of his life working in a leper colony. He also applied his faith and experience to written reflections on pain and suffering, sometimes in collaboration with Philip Yancey. He offers this: "I have come to see that pain and pleasure come not to us as opposite, but as Siamese twins, strangely joined and intertwined. Nearly all my memories of acute happiness, in fact, involve some element of pain or struggle." And John Piper, noted pastor and writer, also reflects on this most human of experience when he says, "I've never heard anyone say, the deepest and rarest and most satisfying joys of my life have come in times of extended ease and earthly comfort." Nobody says that. It isn't true. What's true is what Samuel Rutherford said when he was put in the cellars of affliction: "The great king keeps his wine there, not in the courtyard where the sun shines." What's true is what Charles Spurgeon said: "Those who dive in the sea of affliction bring up rare pearls." In the darkest moments, I need to see what Martin Luther saw hundreds of years ago when he wrote that our Lord God looks on for a while and puts us in a tight place so that we may learn from our own experience that what seems like the small, weak, miserable word, with a capital W, is stronger than the devil and the gates of hell. That word never fails. I believe, Lord. We believe, Lord. Help our unbelief.